Every day we're told being vaccinated is the greatest deterrent against coronavirus. But what happens to those who don't have any vaccine to take? Now, more concerns about poorer nations after the world's largest vaccine manufacturer in India, the Serum Institute, said it would continue its vaccine export ban till at least the end of the year. Newsnight has seen exclusive data from UNICEF showing what countries were told they'd receive from the Institute and what they were actually provided. In recent months, Mozambique has received just 18.6% of what it was told it would get. Afghanistan and South Sudan received 18%, while Uganda, Kenya and Malawi got 28% of their initially allocated amount. In response to the new figures, UNICEF told us,
COVAX partners are in discussion with the Serum Institute to get a better understanding of what the vaccine forecast will look like from now until the end of the year.
Due to a shortfall, it said,
we're urging countries with excess doses to share those doses as an immediate stopgap measure.
India is in the midst of a medical emergency as COVID rips through every corner of its land. Yesterday, the chief executive of the Institute said, India has delivered more than 200 million doses. If we look at total number of doses produced and delivered, we rank amongst the top three in the world. We continue to scale up manufacturing and prioritise India.
The export restrictions in India really do have significant implications for the rest of the world. And that's largely because India was set up to be the primary supplier of vaccines for low middle income countries. And we were expecting more than a billion doses to flow from the Serum Institute alone in 2021.
There are two key questions many will be mulling over as this situation unfolds. One, is India wrong to self-prioritise? With some saying it's dealing with the biggest crisis it has had to cope with since the conflict during partition. And two, how many lives will this cost in other countries, some of which are extremely poor? Already, India has exported to more than 50 countries. Halting exports is a massive blow to COVAX, the global body which aims to get vaccines to poorer countries. The World Health Organization says there's already a shortfall of 190 million doses to COVAX by the end of June.
The plan last year with the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine was to globalize the manufacturing base, and that was done with over 20 sites worldwide making the vaccine for global distribution. A key linchpin of that supply chain was the Serum Institute in India, the world's biggest. Taking them out and them not being able to supply to the globe, only being able to supply in India, is a big blow to that plan.
Malawi has a shortfall of vaccine after it burned thousands of doses because they'd expired, while Kenya says it only has 100,000 doses of AstraZeneca left and is on the cusp of running out. UNICEF is urging G7 countries to donate more supplies.
Even though the situation in India was actually predictable and is a risk we should have anticipated and planned for, we didn't. And so there just is no backup plan for supply for the next few months, this is a really, really critical time. It is very much a race against the virus.
The World Health Organization has been clear. Once the COVID crisis in India subsides, it must get back on track and catch up on its export commitments to COVAX. But the pandemic there rages on, with no clear sign of it letting up anytime soon, while the world decides what to do next.